pitanje od predstavnice. E da questo momento in avanti facciamo così. Ci sarò alla prossima domanda, non ci sarò a quella di Borghi per collezionare le opzioni generali.
Va bene,
allora faccio passare il durante alla lezione fondamentale. Questo quindi non è il viso però.
No, quello è tipo.
Ok, please take a seat. Before I introduce you our next distinguished speaker, just a matter of logistics. Unfortunately, we have this way of certifying the presence at this course, which is this form here. The doctoral school asked us to do it this way. I don't personally like it. However, this is the way it is. Please be careful. If I catch you, any of you signing twice in place of somebody else, and make sure that you are punished in the severest possible way, okay? Let's not kid ourselves. Sign for yourself is the only way we have to know who was roughly here at the lecture, okay? Don't cheat, okay? Now we will pass this form more or less during the middle of the class, so we don't have the big assemblance of people at the end, and sign for yourself, okay? As we say in Italy, uomo avvisato, mezzo salvato. Okay? Now, getting to the next lecture, it's with great pleasure that I introduce to you Professor Angelo Raffaele Meo. Professor Angelo Raffaele Meo, besides being, as the other speakers, an extra trustee, is an emeritus professor of the Polytechnic of Turin, and he has been devoting almost all his life to computer science and computer engineering more specifically. He's one of the handful of people that in the 60s introduced computer science in Italian universities. They're a real handful. And he's the one who introduced it here at the Polytechnic of Turin, starting the whole group of people that eventually became the Department of Computer Engineering to which we both belong. Okay? So he's, during these decades, his interest in computer science and in general in digital matters has been very broad. He has been dealing with natural language processing to free software, and has always had a strong interest in the interaction between digital technology and society, and therefore the context of this course on internet and society is particularly well suited for his interest and his experience. So it's with great pleasure that I welcome Professor Angelo Raffaele Meo and I thank him for having accepted our invitation. Thank you.
And good to you. This lecture is the summary of the course that I have given here. Some students of mine are present today. They cannot leave this room, but they can study something else while I am speaking. First section, the ancient history of creation. The history of free software has a father, or Ramana, the history of Hakka culture. We must not think that Hakka is a synonym of a Kaka. Hakka are not Kakas. Hakka have a very interesting language. For example, Hakka, which means my body. What are you doing? Just hacking. Hack is the tool which can be used to enter into a forest. To hack means, in this case, to try to enter into a computer program in order to understand what he is doing, not in order to damage it. The language contains also the predicates inherited from Lisp. Coffee bee is one of these variables which can take one or two values, true or false. The question coffee bee or tea bee is a wrong question, since or is not exclusive, is inclusive, or one of the Lisp languages, but also of all the programming languages. So the answer to the question coffee bee or tea bee is always true. The correct answer should be given in the form coffee bee and not tea bee, and vice versa. The lexicon is as well interesting. For example, suit is an uncomfortable dress characterized by a strangling device. I don't see in this room no strangling device at all. For extension, by extension, suit is also the man who wears a suit. The strangling device reduces the flow of the blood to the brain. And this fact explains many things about the behavior of a person suit. Another example, syndrome snuffle, situation normal, olfactory. It derives from the language of American soldiers in Vietnam. It is a moment of an economic theory, which I think I have no time to explain you, the theory called disconnectionism. In 1985, finally, the true history of free software begins. The protagonist, the main actor, is the person that you see, Richard Stallman. He was the chief of the team which worked for the information system in the Laboratory of Artificial Intelligence of Massachusetts Institute of Technology. A certain day, he discovered that he needed the code of the source of the printer. So he wrote to the company which produced this printer. Xerox, and asked Xerox the source code of the program. Xerox did not give the permission to see this coming. So he understood that the history of the software were going in the wrong way, So he resigned, founded a new foundation, the Free Software Foundation, and gave it as a first objective the realization, the construction of a new operating system compatible with Unix but free. He gave to this product a name deriving from an old behavior of hacker culture, the recursive definition. Note the definition is GNU. GNU contains the initial letters of the sentence. GNU is not Unix, which means GNU is not the proprietary Unix of AT&T, but it has the same performance. Note that he is dressed with a long dress, blue duck, and keeps in the hand the holy, come si chiama l'aureola, Carlos?
Cosa?
L'aureola.
It's the Eunice.
No, no, come il nome inglese della parola l'aureola. We see, in this case, we are made with the active surface of an hard disk of the first generation. So he presents himself as Saint Ignatius. And as Saint Ignatius, he pronounces his talks generally very strong against the company which produces proprietary software. His ideology is summarized in this slide. Free software is a question of freedom, not of price. We shall return to this concept in a few minutes. Copyright is a violation of the right of knowledge of citizens and discourages collaboration among citizens. Not free software is harmful to education. Indeed, how to explain a behavior and operating system without the source code? Competition of the market produces unuseful duplication of resources. At this point, he afforded the difficult question of the licenses. Now, the situation on licenses is very complex. A real bubble tower. At the bottom of this tower, there is a proprietary software, of which the source code is not known. Above proprietary software, there is a free software, which is a software which has no cost, but of which the source code is not available. So it cannot be modified and detected. At the top of the tower, there is the public domain software, which can be used for any purpose. Also, be connected with proprietary software, which for Stallman is a real serious sin. Therefore, the license proposed by Stallman has various variations. It is called usually copyleft, in contrast with the usual copyright. And copyleft gives the permission to the user of changing code
of realizing many copies of Nietzsche,
of transforming it and selling the products in the language, and so on. Not the tradition of mixing, marrying these products with proprietary. Hayek told you that the first objective of Solomon was the realization of a new operating system. Then, during the work, very often he changed his ideas. Very often he got a lot of new ideas. So the project did not arrive at the end. But in 1991, a young student of Helsinki's university, Linus Torvalds, which was 21 old years, 20 years old at the time, decided to produce the objective of Torvalds. So he produced a new version of a free operating system, which in his honor was called Linux, since his name was Linus Linux. As GNU was the symbol of the operating system of Stone, apparently is the symbol of the new Linux operating system. However, when we speak of free software, generally we give a large importance, a great importance, to something which is less important of another realization of the principles of free software, which is internet. When I present the internet to my students, the students of the first year, I remember a sentence with states, Simon Pietro dragged to the beach the net full of 153 big fishes. They were so many, but the net did not appear. The old miracle has now two or three new miracles. The first is the technological miracle. Indeed, who has worked with the networks of the first generation remembers how difficult it was to connect not 153 computers, but only 10 computers. Now, 2 billion of computers are connected through internet. Second miracle, a miracle social, economical. Indeed, against an old principle, according with his competition is the main tool for the progress, technological progress. A new product, a very, very important product, was born against the laws of the competition, in the spirit of true collaboration. There was a new concept that I wanted to present at this point in time. I think it was. The second miracle is the there is a third miracle, but I will speak of it later if I shall find the time. Generally, we read in some papers that the internet has been the result of military research. This is absolutely not true. Indeed, the history of internet begins in 1957, after the success of Sputnik of the Soviet Union. That success induced the President of the United States to launch a research program called ARPA. ARPA means Advanced Research Project Agency, a project that will be scientific, technological, and also industrial objectives. We see the work of ARPA. One of the first objectives of ARPA was the realization of a network, a worldwide network. At this point, the military commanders had ideas very, very different from the ideas of the men of the academy and the universities. Military commanders dreamed a network specifically designed in order to make easy the connection between the airplane, the ship, and so on. On the contrary, the men of the academies of the university dreamed a network which they called the Intergalactic Network of Science. The leader of this person was James Killian, and Killian was, for the child of the president, became the president of ARPANET. So, ARPANET was born as a network for scientific connection, for scientific diffusion. In particular, this is the first implementation prototype of ARPANET. It connected four university centers, the Utah University, the University of California, Los Angeles, University of California, Santa Barbara, and the Stanford Research Institute, a research institute working with the scientists of the universities. The old idea of circuit switching was substituted by the new idea of packet switching. This is exactly what the military commanders did not want absolutely. They cannot accept that the packet strategic for the objective of defense would be mixed with the packets of the research of the other objectives. At this point, the military commanders left the internet and founded a new network, a new project called MINNET. So, internet is the front exclusively of scientific free research. The brain of the internet is the so-called IETF, as Internet Engineering Task Force. As you see, the chief of IETF dressed in that way, which is meaningful. The rules of IETF are the following. Everything must be free. The scientific principles, the idea. the code, the participation. All we need, they state, is a rough consensus and the running code. Fly before by, fly with the fence, as stated the students in the 68, before by a new idea or a new solution. The scientists who participated to IEDF activity produced a very large number of scientific documents called RFC as a request for comments. IEDF states, write them in the toilet, but write them exact and clean. According to all principles, run consensus, but running code. At this point, the question arises, why a programmer should produce a new product if he has not the permission of making money with his work? The answer is stated by Stromer in these terms. The question of free software is a question of freedom, not of money. Indeed, the money can be done through new models of business. For example, new hardware consultancies, new program specifically written for a specific application. And the standard repeats very often, free as in free speech, not as in idea. He plays with the double meanings of the word free. The English word free means no cost, but means also free. Free is in free speech, a basic concept of the Constitution of the United States of America. Not as in free beer, beer gratis, as wanted the students of the university in the 68 movement. Now, when we speak of free software, generally think of the operating system, Linux, and so on. This is not absolutely correct. The free software is a world of thousands and thousands and thousands of programs. A number very large of programs, much more than the size of the proprietary software. Certain day, Google decided to publish in a new site called Grapple the free software available. According to the first computation, 100 million of pages were accessible. Many billions of search code lines. There is a specialized site called Source Code, which publishes free software when it is available. The collaborators of Source Code, programmers which work for source projects, are now 1 million and 500 and 600 1 million 600,000 working on 150 different projects. I don't see a student from Maria. Students and records, which has collected the contribution of many of my students concerning various fields of theory of free software, which have recently uploaded in internet. If Radio arrives, I will give you the exact address of this site. Section 2, the history of free software in Italy. I think that the question perhaps is not so large interest for foreign students, but it is not true. Since the history of free software in Italy is very similar to the history of free software in the other countries. Let's begin from the year 2002. Lucio Stacca, Minister of the Second Government Berlusconi, constitutes a first committee in order to verify the opportunities opened by the advent of free software for public administration, central and peripheral public administration. He gave me the task of presiding this committee, even if he knew perfectly that I had not his political ideas. Indeed, he has wrote a book of mine which had a red cover, and he called it the Red Book by Mail. Not by now. This is the first slide which I devoted to him, in text, in the day in which we presented the results of the work of the committee. And here I represent the original title only two or three of the slides which I used in that occasion. First question, will the committee analyzed in that case was a proposal, the result of the research developed by a consultancy company of the United States, well known at the international level, called IDC. This was a study commissioned by Microsoft. According to this study, the free software had two main defeats. First, it is not true, according to them, that the cost of the use of a free software product, it is not true, since in two cases, free, the cost of technical consultancies exceed the cost of licenses. It's all question of TCO, total cost of ownership. Second, IDC thought that since the source code is available. It is more easy for crackers to enter into a system, a program, in order to intelligence it. But we think that it is not true. According to in all the principles due to capture the most important protagonist of the history of cryptology, a military cryptology. In 1883, now this year, security through obscurity is bad. We usually state in the conference devoted to cryptology questions, security through obscurity, the so-called store, is as bad with computer systems as it is with women. It is unusual that we men may steal ourselves after the smoke curtain. Oh, I don't know, I don't remember. I will explain later and so on. Women are more clever than we. And so, always they, I don't know the exact English word, she better say that, discover always our sins. And this is true. An important example that comes to my mind in this moment is the case of Enigma. Do you remember Enigma? The cryptological machine which were used, which was used by American forces, not American, Deutsche forces, in order to crypt their messages. Alan Turing and his friends realized relatively easily a machine in order to overcome that difficulty. Now we know that a very, very simple code, not sure, but clear, on condition that the key is sufficient enough, are sufficient in order to avoid that the encrypted message should be discovered. I see the time is running, so I... Another of the requests of the committee was this custom software that is the custom developed for a specific application belongs to public administration. So it should not vary many times, but it should be free. In those years, I don't know whether you remember, it was discovered that Windows NT contained a vector. A vector characterized by two cryptographic keys. The Windows NT key and the National Security Agency key. And it was also discovered that that vector was used also for commercial purposes. So we asked to have the opportunity of inspection of proprietary software in order to verify the absence of vectors. Microsoft accepted on the condition that the scientist with the task of the task of verifying the absence of the cross, signed a non-disclosure agreement. Nobody accepted this invitation. Indeed, in any also small truth about that code could be known, probably those persons who had signed the non-disclosure agreement, their sons, the sons of their sons, and so on, the grandchildren of their grandchildren, and so on, would be obliged to pay money and money and money. Second request. Tremonti and Veltroni must speak in XML. Tremonti was the Minister of Industry, of Technological Development, and Veltroni was the Major of Product. So the sense of the census is the standard of communication, the standard of communication between public administration and between public administration and the citizens, the standard of communication should be open. Notice that in this slide, CMFPC denote both structural technological entities and government public administration entities. So MF is the main trade and is also the Ministry of Finance. PC is the personal computer and also the poor community. CM is the mountain community and also the cellular multimedia cellular. The results of the work of the committee suggested to the minister this law 82/05, known as Code of the Digital Administration. This law states, one, the public administration should compare from the two points of view of cost and of operation functionalities, should compare all the programs comprised the programmi informatici e codice sorgente aperte, open source code, free software. Second, public administration should adopt standard of interoperability available in more than one format, but at least one of these formats should be open. Notice that the committee has suggested only open formats. But when the law was published, there was this difference between the original proposal and the text of the law. Incidentally, some years later, the European community specified and stated that the standard of communication between public administration should be always open. Well, our country, I don't know if other countries have the same specific characteristics. Other countries characterized by very severe laws. But these severe laws are always ignored. And this is always the case of the law. Or the public administration continue to use proprietary software. This is one only interesting example of a competitive tender of an Italian public administration. It was the Ministry of War. I translate only a point of this tender. This competitive tender had an amount, an economic value of about 4.5 million of euros. So it was compulsory to open a European tender, not only a national tender. And so the point that was specified in the tender, the most interesting is the following. Only the sellers of Scrooge Corporation, incidentally, Scrooge Corporation is Microsoft, only sellers of Microsoft can participate to this competitive tender. We, during, worked in order to abolish this tender. And we worked, but we spent a lot of money and a lot of time. And the tenders like this one are generally the rule in our country. The result is that the Italian red box of software has outputs, inputs of 3 gigadollars and inputs of the order of $1. Concerning interoperability, I work very often for the Ministry of Industry in order to evaluate the research industrial projects. And I must give the results of my analysis to a specialized site of the Ministry. That in order to do this, I must go to a room near to the mine, since for ideological reason, I do not use the internet program. And use the machine, the personal computer of a friend, in order to transmit. If you do not talk internet explorers, out of the box, that in Italian is very effective. I don't know whether another language is so. In the consideration of the fact, in consideration of the fact that the law was not accepted, but not applied, the new minister Nicolaides of the new government Prodi created a new committee. I presented also that committee. We worked for about 1 year, produced a book of 400 pages containing rules to be applied in designing the products. But a few days after the end of our work, the government project fell down. At this point, something which I would define my diction of Tutankhamun, of Will Tutankhamun, the companion of Will Tutankhamun. Indeed, all the political men who have worked in the free software researchers, Passerini, Cortiani, Magnoni, Stanca, and so on, disappeared from a political point of view, have disappeared. And the ashes, from the ashes, emerges the new minister of technology. Renato Brunetta. Renato Brunetta told us that the question of free software was of no interest for him, and refused to receive us. Two further examples in order to explain the situation, the reason for which free software is not adopted by public administration. In the summer of 2012, 3 years ago, the Italian Parliament produced a law which stated a public administration can buy a product only when a similar solution in free software is not existing. A very, very strong statement. But a few months later, few days before the date of resigning, the government of Monti produced a new law which certainly had been written by the veteran Microsoft. First, the total question of total cost of ownership was again proposed against the interest of the other country, since for the interest, the economical interest of our country, it is not the same thing to spend the money for buying licenses than to spend the money for the young people who give technical consultancy. Second, standard open, nonché the semantic of Italian word, nonché, means però fai anche, but you are free. Also, you can use standard open, but also you can use standards of interoperability which guarantee a real good performance. And you can ignore the role of the open interoperability standards. Third point, a new proposal of the problem of security, which the scientific community has already overcome. Well, section 3, the technological evolution and the opportunity opened by the technological evolution from the point of view of research. The total knowledge of humanity, of mankind, increases with an exponential growth.
desires, indeed any new knowledge associated to old knowledge produces automatically new knowledge. The proof. Homo sapiens has spent 150,000 years, more than 150,000 years, in order to invent the wheel. If we project the history of Homo sapiens for 1 year, we discover that the wheel was invented in November 18. Then, only 600 years have been sufficient to learn to fly. The airplane has been invented on December 31, at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. And then only 50 years or something, 100 years, in order to reach the moon. The shuttle was invented on December 31 at 11 in the night. Well, exactly in the moment when the curve of total knowledge was straight to the right, a new revolution appeared, which I have symbolized with the pastilla. New revolution of knowledge, the revolution of information. Information technology. The world which surrounds us is made of bodies and sounds. Body is the mistake, the tree, the mountain, everything which I can touch with my hands. Sounds are the ideas, the principles, the same idea of what I can touch with my hands. From a more scientific point of view, the world is made of atoms, the main components of bodies, and bits, the main components of sound. Two slides, a pair of slides, I have summarized the progress of the technologies of bodies and technologies and sounds. Here we see the speed of transportation of bodies. In the high section we see Philippides, the day of the victory of Maratona, the victory of Maratona. He went from Maratona to Athena at a speed of 15 kilometers per hour. At the bottom, we see the shuttle, 30,000 kilometers per hour, with a progress of a factor of 2,000. We should see that the progress of technologies of sounds are very, very, very much higher. Here, the speeds of computation. Pythagoras was able to perform the multiplication two numbers of 4 digits with a speed of 0.02 multiplication per second. Pythagoras knew well Pythagoras table comprised the section left and right, which I do not have anymore. Gauss learned by heart the table of logarithms, and so improved his field. He was able to perform one multiplication and 0.1 multiplication per second. At the end, the personal computer is able of performing 1 billion of multiplication per second. Floating point. This is the pearl of computation. He is a multi-chip. He is able to perform 1 teraflop, 1,000 billion of the arithmetic operation in floating points. The speed of transmission of information in the high section, we see the transmission by smoke. The cost of 2 cents per mega is able to transmit at the distance of 1,000 kilometers information of the order of 10 terabits per second. 10 millions of millions of bits per second. More than the whole telephonic traffic of the world. If a cellular telephone like this one were made with electronic type tubes, the old parts, it would be large as pattern. Pen drive 256 gigabytes. The content of the whole library of 150,000 books. The new technologies change the world of product innovation. Indeed, any product which surrounds us, from the washing machine to the super bombers, the aircraft that we see, the tools of war that I do not like, but fantastic from the point of view of scientific science. No pilot should be able to drive an aircraft like this one. Well, all the products include the transistors. This slide summarizes the size of the transistors. We, men and women, in this planet, are about 8 billion, 10 to 10, 10 by 10. For every man and woman in our planet, 1 billion and 500,000 ants are living. I don't know whether has been made this computation. However, it is not strange. Indeed, about 10 to 7 adherents living in my house. Contrasted by my wife with chemical weapons, chemical weapons, without any success. For any end, the microelectronic institute produces every year 10 transistors. So for every man or woman, the industry produces hundred millions. No, 10 million. 10 million for the moment. Parallel to this product innovation is the process innovation. I summarize the process innovation by making reference to a history, an old history, which I loved when I was a child. Many years ago, the supervisor of Professor Lombardi. The supervisor had this facility. If we give the supervisor to figures, to designs, to images, and so on, immediately these images become real. I love the cycle on the wall near my house, and I would have liked to have a bottle of the super famous. Later, some years later, I had the dream of another application here of the super paint, different from the production of the recyclers. Some scientists now state that the super paint of persons are here to come. It is absolutely false, according to my opinion. Indeed, the biological superpaint exists in each of our cells. The ribosome makes this work, converts the bits of RNA messenger into the proteins corresponding. The biological superpaint exists, but it is not available to the man in this moment. Indeed, a molecule of DNA, which was not discovered, as we read, by Crick and Watson, but by Franklin, Eleanor Franklin, a young girl. DNA, the most important discovery in the history of mankind, is made, contains a number written in code. This number has the order of 2 billion of decimal digits. For years, mathematicians has discussed which is the largest number. Well, the largest number as a Google is 10 high 100. and so on. Well, the number written in DNA is this scale, which is a logarithmic scale, not a linear scale, is in this scale 25 kilometers over the ceiling of this room. And this number is repeated exactly equal to itself in each of the you are a little fat, eh? No? Little fat? You have 100,000 or billions of cells. In each of these cells, this large number is written. This gives us the idea of how large, how distant we are now from the production, automatic production of girls. Now biology does not explain lives as the algorithm does not explain integers. I do not believe in artificial intelligence, but I have no time to discuss this question. This is the super point of cars. This is a machine for producing many, many pieces. And this assembly operations. Now we have the super pen. And then I have forgotten the question. Indeed, I intended to present a bit about the time. Is near the oven. On free hardware. 1 year ago, in Italy, there was a small area which was called the Kingdom of Italy. The area has a center of gravity near Ivrea. It was a very small about the size of Elgin. Well, exactly 1,000 years after the death of the Kingdom of Italy, 5 students or professors of a school of Ivrea met in a restaurant, a coffee room, called Arduino King of Italy. Well, they decided to design a new line of hardware products in order to use this object in the application of schools. And so they invented Arduino hardware, which is something the idea had a great success since they made their project absolutely free. Any person, any project designer can use the project, the data of the project, and copy it and produce new variant of the. And this has been a great success. One day I received the visit of an Indian colleague who showed me a small personal computer for learning activity, for the activity in the schools, of the cost of $12. It was based on Arduino hardware. The three-dimensional printer, which is a real super paint the big super painter, since we enter with the drawing and go out with the physical painting. Used in many Fab Labs is based on acrylic. One example, meaningful. I gave to two students of mine a difficult task to afford the problem of the world champion of sfiga, traducetemi la parola sfiga.
Bad luck.
The persons, the men, who do not hear and do not see. Blind, deaf. I proposed them to use a code with the attributes to which of the parts of the fingers of the hands, the code for the letter. They arrived some months later with a new idea to use a language, a variant of the sign language. I don't know whether you see the agreement with the translate in the sign language the news from the book. The strike on the flight controllers, for example. A variant of this code can be obtained by moving the hands of the deaf. In this situation, according to the code. But in order to implement that solution, they needed a robotic arm. The robotic arm costed 150 euros. And so they went to the Fab Lab, during Fab Lab, designed the robotic arm and arrived to me with the robotic arm and the whole system implemented. In this moment, their work is experimented on some person that landed. Incidentally, the three-dimensional printer has suggested to the most important review of economy, The Economist, this image and an important paper, they called the invention of the three-dimensional printer, they called it the third industrial revolution. It is far away from the moment, but the revolution is important. I would have liked to explain at this point a question much more important than those I have discussed. The summary is this. The revolution is making possible a better future based on collaboration, not on competition. But the condition to reach, the first condition to reach is to abolish the patent and the concept of intellectual property. And I intended to present 10 arguments against the patents. Since my time is over, I limit myself to show you one example. Please make an experiment. Go to your computer. Go to Google and write patent and any word you comes to your mind in that moment. And see how many patents are there. This is the result of the research of toilet patents. And you see at the right the explanation for dogs and cats, you know that they do and use our patent project. A tool to be connected to the car, the same object introduced in the car, and so on. And above one, at the left in the high section, a real marvelous invention, technological invention, a tool which has the purpose of avoiding that the mail goes outside of the border. It is based on a two-dimensional analysis of sensors. The CPU evaluates the center of gravity of the jet. And when the center of gravity of the jet goes near to the border, an image on the screen corrects, tries to correct the jet. It is an example meaningful for a presentation, but if you read with attention the patents for which the American courts condemned Samsung and the Asian courts condemned Apple, you see exactly things like this one. The patent has no meaning anymore, and it is necessary to abolish this country. I apologize that the most important thing that I intended to present you, the future is no more based on competition, as the David states, but will be based on collaboration. Free software is the symbol of this new world. Thank you, I apologize.
Thank you to Professor Mayer for his really interesting presentation. Now if you have some questions, let's say like 5-10 minutes or more, already out of time, but if you have some questions, please ask them to Professor Lin.
Is it okay?
It's too late. They are hungry.
Who asks a question will be killed immediately.
Software developers develop software streaming and put them on the market and for public use. And what is the motivation of companies in order to develop software if they cannot, you know, do the competition or what would be the motivation?
The motivation should be to sell software. Software can be sold, but it must remain free. Sold once, it will not be possible to sell it again.
That one time.
But the company can continue to improve the product and sell it to develop new applications. Thank you.
be software, open source?
Software should be but open source does not mean that it can be given like free as a procedure. No.
Okay.
Thank you again.
Thank you. Do you have other questions?